Alrighty, next on my list of OSC controls, we're going to look at controlling the sky. So instead of building a new blueprint, I'm actually going to use my HQ Sky blueprint, simply because it's free on Gumroad and it's got everything contained in a blueprint already. It saves me a lot of time. So go ahead and download it. It's a plugin, so put it in your plugins folder. Then once you have it enabled, we can hit settings here and we can go show plugin content. Then here it is, HQ Sky. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag that into our content here, and then I'm going to hit copy here because we'll make a copy because we'll be editing this blueprint. Also, because it annoys me, I'm going to put BP in front of it. So then I can simply delete everything that makes up this pretty average looking sky and instead drag this out. And that gets us something a bit nicer. So let's go ahead and get started. Open up the blueprint. Here we go. Can delete all of these. So everything for this blueprint is contained in the construction script, but how it works is they're actually all functions here. So create clouds, set cloud properties, all that sort of stuff. The beauty of that is all we need to do with OSC is set the variable values, the exact same variables that you usually control to change the sky, and then run these functions. So it's quite simple. So I'm going to start class settings. We're going to add the interface we created before. So BPI OSC interface like so. Compiler, and then I'm going to search for the OSC message, and then at the very top, event OSC message. So as from before, this is the event that gets triggered once we sort of broadcast out our interface. So I'm going to promote the message contents to variable. Here we go. Yep, leave it as is. Draw blank on that for a minute. We're also going to need a few strings for our comparing. So I'm going to start by doing a get message address. Here we go. Then I'm going to convert it to a string. So in OSC, I've actually already set up some controls. So we have for the sun height, I've got this fader knob here. Then I've got an encoder here, which just spins either way for the sun offset. Then these ones I've got for the volumetric fog amount and the cloud amount. So for that, I'm going to need four strings. So I'm going to make a new one. I'm going to call this one sun height. I'm going to make them all public, like so. Switch them all to string. All right, on one of them for category, I'm going to delete the word default, and I'm going to type OSC like so, which create a new category, and then I'm going to simply drag these onto OSC category as well, just to keep things nice and neat. Perfecto. Next, we need a few branches. Alrighty, a lot of repetition there because I just had to do everything four times over, but we've done a equals exactly on our string value variables here, and then we've got a bunch of branches. I created a heap of custom events to be triggered for all of that, so update sun height, update sun offset, cloud density, fog density, and then called them on the branches. Pretty straightforward, exactly like the previous tutorial, except times it by four. So now we're going to start, which is actually just going to be a bit more repetition. So I'm going to get our OSC message contents here. I'm going to get the float from it at index. like so. For the sun height, we just simply have a fader value, which is going to be 0 to 1. I'm going to grab this, I'm going to map range clamped like that. So instead of 0 to 1 here, outrange, let's have a look. So there's no stars in this system, so basically we'll go from completely dark, so negative 10, to probably positive 90, which is directly overhead. So negative 10 to positive 90, like so. Then I'm going to find the sky sun, here we go, sun height. I'm going to set it to this value. And then I'm simply going to call set sun values the function. That's all we need to do. We just need to do that three more times. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, paste it down here. Now, the update sun offset is actually an encoder, like so. So this is not an absolute encoder. So what it does is when it's not moving, it's 0. When it's moving clockwise, it's positive 1. And when it's moving counterclockwise, it's negative 1. So what we need to do then is slightly change how we do our setup here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the sun offset. I'm going to get it first, like so. Then I'm going to set it as well. And then I'm going to grab this value and I'm going to add it to this one and then set it. So, and then we simply set the sun values again. So what's happening here is every time this one is called, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be adding to, or if we're spinning counterclockwise, taking away from the current value, setting it as the new value, and then updating the sum position. So that'll let us sort of spin it around like a wheel, and it'll move the sun around. Alright, so the last two are finished. It's exactly the same as the first one. We're simply grabbing the first float in the message contents. I fiddled with the values to find some good ones for the range, set it, and then run the, in this case, set fog values and set cloud properties for the respective. They are back the front. Oops, that would have been confusing. Cloud for cloud, fog for fog. Perfect. Compile and save. So here's the basics of it. If you wanted to add more controls to this, it's simply a matter of adding more of those. But now, just like before, we have our little OSC values down here. So we can jump into OSC here and find them. So enable the editor. So this one's knob underscore one. Encoder 3, fader 3, and fader 4, I think. Encoder 3, fader 3, and fader 4. Let's double check they are, in fact. Fader 3, fader 4. Perfect. Now let us set everything back to default. Alright, so now we should be able to, there we go. Sun up, sun down. Nice early morning sky. Then our encoder should let us spin, there we go. So we can spin the sun around, raise it up, spin it back the other way. Looks so cool. Now this one, what do we make this one? Clouds, there we go. Clouds disappear, and now it's overcast. And not very foggy, really foggy. Make that early foggy morning look. So if you want to go ahead and add in more controls to the sky, maybe you want the cloud height or the second cloud, or whether it's volumetric fog or not, anything like that, you can go ahead and add in to OSC now. You know, we've got a lot of different switches and buttons and stuff to fiddle with, so perfect time to do all that. But hopefully this was informative. I'm going to continue with a few other OSC things, just so eventually we should get a nice OSC controller that, and then I'm going to throw it all on Gumroad so you guys can download it if you like. But basically this is the essentials, the building blocks for what we usually use on set with this sort of stuff for directors to control or someone else to control based on director's feedback. So, thank you for watching, guys.